On this layer is the pencil sketch. On the top is the ink line art. Lock your pencil sketch layer, this way you won't work on it by accident. The ink line art is active. Grab the magic wand. Click anywhere on the canvas. If all your lines are well connected, meaning that there are no gaps between them, you will get a well-defined selection. By clicking on the button located in the very bottom left corner of the interface, you will be able to change the way you see the selection. This functionality is quite useful for those of us who cannot see the marching ants very well. The pink represents what is not selected, and the transparent represents our selection. So what this means here is that the background has been selected, not the bird. And by the way, to undo this view, just click again on the same button and the marching ants will be back. Obviously, we want the opposite. We want the bird to be selected, not the background. Let's create a new layer between the line art and the sketch layer. In the color wheel, select a color. Any color will do. Now let me show you what I meant earlier. I am going to fill the selection with the color I just selected. As a reminder, to fill a selection with a color, hit the Shift and Backspace keys on your keyboard. And here it is. We did indeed select the background, not the bird. There is an easy way to fix that problem. First, let's undo all of that. Go to Select and choose Invert Selection. If I click on the button again, you will see that the bird is transparent now, meaning it has been selected. We can fill the selection with our color. Hit Ctrl+Shift+A to undo the selection. Hit F2 and rename the layer base color. Create a new layer on the top of the base color layer. Holding the Shift key on your keyboard, select both layers. Now hit the letter G to create a group. Make sure to click on the new layer you have created to activate it. Lock the alpha inheritance. The trick to a great coloring workflow is to start painting the shadows and highlights. So let's rename this layer S for shadows. Change the blending mode to multiply. Decrease the opacity of the layer to about 59% or less. In the color wheel with a color set to blue, choose a mid-range gray. Make sure that your pen pressure is off and start painting your shadows. By the way, if your pen stabilizer is on, I would advise you to turn it off. You can do so by setting it to none. Paint your shadows very roughly first, and then use your eraser to shape them. When you are done, play with the different opacity settings of your layer to find out which amount is best for your project. Create a new layer on the top and rename it H for highlights. set the blending mode to screen. Some of you may prefer overlay. Just choose the one that fits best to your project. In the color wheel, choose a lighter gray tint. Just like earlier, pen your highlights very roughly and then refine them with the eraser. Now that you are done, you are going to, again, play with the opacity slider of your layer and find which intensity is best for your project. Just as a quick tip, don't overdo the highlights. The less, the better. Click on the base layer to activate it. We are going to create a few layers above it. They all need to be underneath the shadows and highlight layers. That's very important. We'll create a layer for the beak, the feet, the eyes, and etc. We can always remove the layers we won't need later. What you can do is rename the layers as you go. I'll rename the first one beak. In the color wheel, choose the first color and color the beak. You don't need to log the alpha inheritance for items located within the base color. I usually log the alpha inheritance when I color things that are close to the edges. Rename the next layer feet and paint the feet. Now don't worry about the colors you are choosing now because you can always change them later. This time, lock the alpha inheritance. It will make your work go faster. Now paint the clothes using another color. I don't like this color, it's too bright, so let me use a darker tone. Alright, that's much better. Time to paint the eyes, maybe rename your layer Iris. Now that you are done, you are going to rename the next layer White of Eyes, maybe. In the color wheel, choose a lighter tone of the same color. We are almost done. We are going to now color the body, so rename the layer body. I don't think we are going to need more layers, so we can remove any extra layers. Grab your layer and move it all the way down. It must be placed above the base color layer. In the color wheel, choose your new color. Lock the alpha inheritance of the layer. And using the shortcut Shift plus Backspace, you are going to fill the layer with your color. This final step is only if you need to do it. Maybe you are happy with the colors you chose in the first place. In my case, I want to touch up a few things, so I'll go to each layer and using the Ctrl plus U functionality, I am going to tune my colors. And voila, you are done. The very last thing you can do if you want is create a brand new layer at the very top. Using a white color, just draw two white dots on the eyes. So we are done for today. I hope this little tutorial was helpful. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.